It's helpful to look at these thumbnails because even with the animation, this is the way it's going to be when it's printed. So when I look at these three panels, that second panel isn't the way I want it to look. I'd really like him to be kind of midway through this. So I need to do what's called adding a snapshot if I want it to print out the way that I want it to. So once again, I can switch over to the timeline workspace, or you can enable a timeline any place you want to by hitting this plus symbol. And I'll scroll down to timeline. Man, I've actually added a timeline next to the thumbnails. And that's the sort of thing you can do on a lot of these areas, is add and move around the different palettes. In this case, the timeline. I'm going to click here and press the number 2 on my keyboard to make this a bit bigger. So I want to sort of freeze him in the middle here when it prints out. And the way that I'll do that is by right-clicking or pressing Control-click and choose Add Snapshot. And you'll see a blue arrow appears, and that's the symbol for a snapshot. That doesn't affect anything at all in terms of the animation, but what it will do is control your thumbnail, and it will control the way that it prints out. So now I can look at the thumbnails, and you could see a very distinct difference between these two panels, whereas they used to look the same before. This way it'll print out very nicely.